Hello guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to the second episode of MotoGP News, a weekly series that we have started just last week in which we take a look at all the important events happening in the MotoGP world over the past 1 week. This is the second episode and in case you have missed the first episode, I will leave it in the cards above. Please make sure that you go and check it out and stay up to date with whatever is happening in the MotoGP world. So guys, without further delay, let's get right into the video. The first news is coming from Casey Stoner as he praises Remy Gardner. The MotoGP and Australian legend Casey Stoner has gone on to say that he is really happy with the way Remy Gardner has secured a contract in 2022 with the KTM Trek 3 Dream. He has said a lot of good and positive words about Remy Gardner. Casey went on to say that Remy came into his own this year and we have seen him mature even more in the past few years. These are some really awesome words from the Australian legend. And Casey Stoner also went on to add that he was really excited to see two Australians battling it out on the 2022 grid, and that's really amazing. So guys, the next news coming in is from Alex Rins. Alex Rins is confirmed that he will be back at Germany for the Sachsenring Grand Prix. So guys, Alex Rins, as we all know, has had a bicycle accident due to which he had to undergo a surgery, because of which he had to miss the race at Catalonia. But there is good news coming in that Alex Rins will definitely be back at the German Grand Prix at Sachsenring. After the surgery, there were rumors that he is expected to be back, but now the news is confirmed that he definitely will be back. Alex Rins desperately needs to come back and have a good result for himself as well as Suzuki, because over the past few races it has just been a horrid start for him, and he really needs a change in fortune to actually help him climb up the ladder again. So guys, after that we move to the next news, which is fans will be allowed in Motorland Aragon. So guys, the Aragon Grand Prix will be coming and the MotoGP grid will be moving to Aragon in September, and the good news is that fans will be allowed at the circuit. MotoGP expects a sale of about 20,000 tickets for the race at Motorland Aragon, and they will also have another look in the month of August to see how the COVID situation is, and depending on that further decision will be taken. But so far the news is that fans will be allowed in the Motorland Aragon. Guys, our last news is coming from Moto3. There have been many new rules that have been introduced for the Moto3 class. There are rules that have been introduced that come into effect from right now, that come into effect from next year, and some of them also come into effect from the year after that. But for this news, we are just going to look at the rules that come into effect right now, and I will be making a separate video on all the rules that have been updated for the Moto3 class. So for now guys, the riders go into Q1 and Q2 depending upon the combined free practice time. But what happens is that there are certain penalties to be given to the riders because of exceeding track limits, and the teams have to go to the stewards and complain about the situation. But what happens because of this is time is lost and the teams do not get enough time to prepare for qualifying 1 and qualifying 2. So to fix this, the new rule has come. According to this rule, the riders going into Q2, directly into Q2, or the free practice times will be finalized 60 minutes after the free practice 3 session ends, which will give the teams enough time to protest against a decision that they think is wrong, and which will give them enough time to prepare as well. And the Q1 results, the qualifying results, will be finalized 5 minutes after the qualifying session ends. This is to ensure that the teams can protest and also protest a wrong decision, and they can also have time to, you know, set up the bike for the next session. So guys, any infringement or any reporting done after the 60 minutes or after the 5 minutes will not be considered. So guys, that was the rule that was coming into effect right now. We will talk about the other rules in a separate video. So guys, that was it for this video. Please let me know what you think about the video, what you think about the series. This is the end of the video. Guys, if you liked what you see, please do not forget to hit the like button. If you disliked what you see, hit the dislike button twice. Also guys, if you're new to my channel and interested in motorsport and MotoGP content, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and ding the notification bell. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.